everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another partial derivatives problem today. This one is f of xy equals the natural log of x squared plus y squared. So the first thing that we need to realize with this problem is that we are doing a partial derivative problem. So we need to take the partial derivative of f with respect to x and the partial derivative of f with respect to y. So because we have the natural log of a quantity, x squared plus y squared, that is more complicated than the natural log function in its pure state, just the natural log of x, we're going to need to use chain rule because we've got x squared plus y squared, which is more complicated than x. So we have chain rule here that we need to use. And then on top of that, because we're going to be taking partial derivatives, we're going to need the derivative formula for the natural log function. So we have the derivative of the natural log of x equals 1 over x. So to use both of these formulas to take the partial derivatives with respect to both x and y, the first thing that we're going to do is apply chain rule. So for the partial derivative of f with respect to x, using chain rule, we're going to first take the derivative of the outside function, which is the natural log function, and then leaving the inside function, x squared plus y squared, completely alone, then we'll multiply that by the derivative of the inside function. So as you can see here, taking the derivative of the outside function, ln of x, knowing that the derivative of the natural log function is 1 over x, where we end up with 1 over x squared plus y squared, meaning we leave the inside of this function here intact. Then, because our chain rule formula tells us to multiply by the derivative of that inside function, x squared plus y squared, we're going to multiply by the derivative of the inside function. But because we're taking the partial derivative with respect to x, the derivative of that inside function, x squared plus y squared, we have to take the derivative of that with respect to x. So in this case, we treat y as a constant and x as our variable. So if x is our variable, we take the derivative as we normally would, and the derivative of x squared is 2x. We treat y as a constant, which means that y squared is a constant, and the derivative of y squared is just 0. So the derivative, in this case, of that inside function is just 2x. So then, of course, we simplify, and we get our final answer here for the partial derivative of f with respect to 2x, which is 2x over x squared plus y squared. Now, with the partial derivative of f with respect to y, we do the exact same thing. We take the derivative of the outside function, so we say it's going to be 1 over x, but instead of that x, we replace it with, you know, our inside function, which we're leaving alone when taking the derivative of the outside. So we leave x squared plus y squared here on the bottom. Then we multiply by the derivative of that inside, x squared plus y squared. In this case, we're taking the partial derivative with respect to y. So we treat y as our variable and x as our constant. So treating y as the variable, that y squared here in our original problem becomes 2y, and the x squared here is going to be 0 because we treat x as a constant, so x squared ends up being a constant. And so multiplying by the derivative of that inside function with respect to y just gives us 2y. So then we simplify to get our final answer. And now you can see we've taken the partial derivative of f with respect to x, and we have our final answer here. And then the partial derivative of f with respect to y, and we have our final answer there. So that's it. I hope it helped, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!